find boards downstairs to patch window.
Hey, Henry?
Yeah.
What do you look like?
Why are you asking?
Because I'm horribly superficial.
I could be Tom Cruise's good-looking twin brother.
Oh, that's too bad. I read in People he's like 5 foot nothing.
Yeah, well, you can't win them all.
Okay, well, that gives me a good start. Now let's see. In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy wearing shorts.
It's hot. And maybe, by the way, I'm not white. It's not very, you know, PC or whatever they say.
Oh my god, you are the whitest man. Wow. I don't need a spotting scope for that. And if not shorts, then what do you normally like to wear?
Clothes. I don't really think about it.
Oh, come on.
I got a sweatshirt I like. Good jacket I got at the Buckle Barn.
Ooh, I love the Buckle Barn.
Just one of those brown ones, you know?
I do. Now tell me about your face. I'm looking at you across the bar. What do I see?
This is weird.
Well, I have a thin mustache, real thin mustache. I got a long scar, goes down across my eye and down my cheek.
Well, I just happen to have a thing for thin mustaches. The thinner and pervier, the better.
Well, then you are in luck.
And a horrible scar. Just perfect. I want to know about your eyes.
Get out of here.
I'm drawing you. I need to know.
Whoa.
You're what?
Is that okay?
Not really.
Don't answer. I'm gonna do it regardless.
Fine.
Your eyes, tell me.
They look tired, I think.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you know, you hit a certain age and you think you're a younger person who just looks tired all the time.
Speak for yourself, mister.
But I guess that's getting old.
Well, some people might see distinguished. Okay, got it. Thank you, Henry.
You get what you need?
Absolutely.
Of course, the moment that she said she was drawing us, the first thing we should think about is Julia. The picture that Julia drew of us. May 3rd, 1989. Think today's gonna be normal, although Delilah is having a hell of a time getting the communications wire fixed. These girls did a real bang-up job fucking us over. A few days before I left, I got a call from Jules' dad. Realized I hadn't really talked to him over the past few years, as much as I thought. I think I was so worried about getting Madeline on the phone whenever I would call that I just stopped calling altogether. Guessing Madeline is Jules' dad? Or Jules' mom. I guess that's the sort of thing writing all this stuff down is supposed to make us realize. Anyway, Mick just wanted to see how I was doing and wanted to have me out. And I appreciated it because he's got that ain't no worries bloke attitude, but it doesn't feel right. I bet Madeline's been hard on him, goddamn. Here's something else I realized. Jules liked my parents. She liked them both, but that didn't stop her from laying into me with, "You're acting like your father." And I realize now that I love the parts of her that she got from Mick. And the parts of her that she got from Madeline scared the living shit out of me. Except for the whole looks department. No denying she lucked out there. I wish we could pick that up. It's really difficult to read. Yeah. Anyways, we should probably go get some boards so we can fix our goddamn window. God. God damn this shit. So what do I usually do around here anyway? If nothing's going on, am I just supposed to like wander around and hope that no one's doing anything illegal or what? A few more boards. Can I get those? There's a board right here. Oh. Yeah, this would be good for whacking any intruders with. Ha! God damn it. A cistern. Ah, we actually have a running water source. Cool. So that's all the way linked up to... Is that for the boiling water or what? I don't even know what that's for. My god. Jonesy Lake. Well, it's a nice, beautiful day today. Yeah. Nice, beautiful day. Better get the window fixed before it stops being beautiful, right? There you go. Is it that easy?
I got that window all patched up. So, what should I do now? What's next?
What's next? What do you think is next?
Well, you've been the one giving me tasks for 2 days straight.
What's next is you sit in that room until September 1st and call me at the first sign of smoke.
Oh. Sounds good.
Yeah.
Why don't you let me know when you're mentally prepared for that task and I'll give it to you.
I don't know, man. When am I ever ready for work? I mean, if I can avoid it, I don't want to work. We've actually gone to quite a few different places now, huh? Kind of. Mysterious fence over there. Still haven't gone to Thoroughfare Lookout yet. Why not?
Okay, I think I am ready to tackle my long-term commitment of keeping this national forest safe from total destruction.
I am glad to hear you've...
Oops, sorry.
...really thought this through.
Of course.
We've issued you a comfy chair to sit in and everything.
You know, it's not really that comfy. It's wooden and there's no padding. I think I actually got a splinter in my thigh this morning.
Aww. Well, regardless, take a seat. The forest depends on you.
Oh! Okay. Day 9.
Hello, Henry. Having a nice afternoon?
Not too bad. I could get used to it out here.
That's nice. Look, I called with bad news. Two young women, Chelsea Stevens and Lily McLean, were reported missing. They've got parents out in California who haven't heard from them in a week. They were supposed to meet an aunt down in Cody. If they're the girls from last week, then you're probably the last person to have seen them.
Shit.
You should tell whoever that I'm happy to be questioned.
Look, it's not gonna be an issue. I mean, if they turn up dead, then maybe. Should I just not say anything and save us the trouble?
No, we're talking about lives here.
I think it's worth mentioning something.
Yeah, I'll keep it vague. I really don't want to talk to the cops.
Me neither.
All right, Henry, thanks. Enjoy the sunset.
You too. Day 15. We're getting along with Delilah.
Henry, wake up. Get out of bed and pick up the radio.
What's up?
What do you want?
Hey, you big dumb idiot.
What?
Hi, Jules.
Oh, you sound tired.
I am.
Are you having a nice time?
I don't know. There's some weird stuff going on.
Oh, that's too bad.
I'm sure it'll be fine.
Well, I'll let you get back to sleep. sleep then.
Okay, Jules.
Delilah seems nice.
Mm-hmm, sure.
Bye, baby.
What? Are we hallucinating? Retrieve.
Is it too much of a pain in the ass to bring supplies all the way up to our towers?
Well, I get my stuff hand-delivered.
Oh, how's that work?
It's the perks of a decade of service. You're out hiking in 90-degree heat, and I get to do crosswords. Isn't life miserably unfair? Anyway, when you find the supply drop, remember it's not just for you, okay? Other lookouts, biologists, a few people get their food there, and I don't want to have to call in for more. There should be loads of good stuff, though. Beans, prunes, jerky. You know, my sister eats 6 prunes a day. 6. She's, like, really precise about it. She'd be great at this job if she didn't need wheelbarrows full of marijuana to function.
Isn't it amazing how a different time of day can make the place look completely different?
So, like, 2 weeks ago, you called me in the middle of the night? You were sleeping, I guess, and all I heard was the name Jules through the mumbles. I just thought it was so sweet. I wanted to wake you up, but then I thought maybe you were having a nice conversation and I'd just be spoiling it. I hope you're doing okay, you know, when it comes to her. Look. So, a couple of months before I took this job, I was with this guy, Javier. Ugh, he's incredible, caring, sexy as hell. He was a driller down in Casper. We dated for almost 5 years. I was working with the Wyoming Outdoor Leadership School, and I was obsessed with it. I wanted to be an instructor so badly. And I was sure I was going to marry Javier as soon as I could be bothered. Walls was also a good excuse to get out of town, drink whiskey in the mountains, cut loose. Then, Javier's brother got killed working in Gillette, and for some reason, I didn't come home. Javier said it was fine, he'd go to the funeral, take care of his mom, stuff like that, it'd be easier solo. When he came back, he left me. I came out here, I lied and told my sister he fucked our neighbor. So, I lied to you. I came out here with a broken heart just like you. I figured you've told me so much about you, so, you know, there's something about me. We both fucked up.
Number one way to get sympathy from somebody. Tell them a story about yourself that is pretty close to what they experienced themselves. So, not trusting this woman a whole lot. And I just noticed this. Was someone trying to rappel down here? Not even rappel, because they would have just dropped down really far. Holy crap. Oh! Is that why the backpack was here? Hey, I wonder if we can get there. I don't think so, but interesting to think about. Still pretty as ever. There's a supply drop again. Oh yeah, we dropped down here. Remember when we came here before? There were no supplies. So, I wonder who refilled them. My god. I thought someone was standing there for a second. Just a fence. Oh my god. It is literally like a painting. Alright.
Found the supplies.
Oh, good. Enjoy.
yeah, don't take their stuff. I can end the day. I assume if we end the day, then we don't have to... Like, we'll just move on. So, let me have a quick look around here. Do you think we can try going to the cable car again? It's getting a little bit late, but... Doesn't hurt to try. Huh. No, huh? Alright.
Alright. I got everything I need out of here. Time to chow down.
Just yours, right?
Who do you think I am?
Got a front row seat for what might be the biggest fire of the year.
Yeah, it's really going.
I'm gonna call it in. They'll send in a hotshot crew for some suppression, but I bet we'll be stuck with her for the rest of the summer. And she doesn't have a name yet. I usually think of something funny or something practical or a little risque when coming up with them. But why don't you do the honors?
Delilah's a nice name.
No, you big dummy.
I was kidding.
No, you were not. You're sweet, but we can't call it the Delilah Fire.
Okay, what then?
How about my middle name, June?
The June Fire, even though it's July.
I like it.
Should I go take a look at it?
So there's this creek down the hill. And, you know what my favorite thing to do is?
What's that?
I love to take a bottle of whatever I have on hand, plunge it deep into the water, and let it chill in there all day. And then, on nights like tonight, when it is so disgustingly hot, I have something nice and cool to drink. I learned that from my sister in Santa Fe. She'd do that with a bottle of tequila near her house and make margaritas the size of your head. You'd like it there.
Oh, what is that?
I'm sure I would. Sounds pretty great.
It is. Are you looking at the fire?
No, I'm not.
You should. Let me know when you are.
Is it too far for me to go over there?
Okay, I'm looking at it again.
I love how they look at night. During the day, it's just smoke, but when the sun is down, you can just get lost.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're here.
Why do you say that?
Because I do. I'm not crazy. I mean, we've had such a good time, right?
Yeah, I think so.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you. Not in the same way. And I know you're not really available, but... I want you to know, well... Maybe it'd be nice to get together at the end of the summer. Look, we don't have to plan or even talk about it. I'm just having the thought. I wish I was over there.
I don't know about this.
It'd be nice to be near somebody. We could talk without these radios. We could, you know.
What? What could we do?
Well, let me tell you.
Whoa!
Fishing without a license?
It's one fish, and I'm sick of all the stuff I got to eat.
Well, I won't tell anyone you're a poacher. That reminds me, I keep hearing reports from Fish and Game about a problem bear they're trying to keep tabs on. Can you search around the lake for fresh tracks and just let me know what you find? There was a crew burning fire lines out to the east, and, you know, I think sometimes it riles up the wildlife.
Does problem actually mean murderer? Like how Charles Manson is a problem cult leader?
Oh, come on. You just have to look for tracks. That's it.
Yeah, well, I've seen what they can do to a tree, and trees aren't even food.
Thank you, Henry.
Yeah.
It looks like we're developing a little something with Delilah here. It's hard. The whole summer, just the two of you? We're not exactly available, but we're in like this emotionally vulnerable position, which kind of makes us available. I don't know. I'm not sure if I like how it's going. I mean, we're still married. Obviously, I'm just gonna keep walking around holding this. Alright.
Someone left their clipboard out here.
Huh. It could have been one of the fish and game folks. See if there's a name or a credential or something. I can call it in.
Someone's diary?
What the? It's... Holy shit.
What's going on? You didn't actually find a bear, did you?
Someone has written down what we said to each other, have been saying.
That doesn't make any sense.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you, not in the same way.
No way.
Wait, hold on. Something's out here.
Henry? I'm worried. You didn't find and eat any mushrooms, did you? I mean, they can be fun, but also, you know, devastating.
One second. How do I pull the fishing rod out again? Anyways, that's not important. Oh, I can't find the clipboard again, I don't think. Wait. Yeah, I can't find it again. But I wanted to look at the top of it again, because it had a station name on it.
Regardless, just let me know, okay, Buckaroo? Oh god, I don't know why I just called you that.
Can we not just fish, please? Oh god.
I found a walkie-talkie out here, too.
Okay.
It's going shithouse.
Well, get it if you haven't already, and then we'll figure out whose it is.
Will do.
Whoa! Shit!
Henry? Are you there? What happened, Henry?
I got hit in the head. Punched or something by someone.
Are you serious? What the hell is going on out there?
I don't know. Jesus Christ.
Let me get this straight. You found a clipboard with, what, transcripts of our conversations? What else is on it?
I don't know. It's gone, along with a radio of theirs. Somebody out here could have just killed me, Delilah.
What the fuck is going on?
What's Wapiti Station?
Yeah, that.
I don't know.
I saw the name Wapiti Station right before I was cold cocked. Does Wapiti Station mean anything to you?
Wapiti Meadow. Maybe it's Wapiti Meadow. It's on our maps. It's not too far from where you are right now. It's where you saw that damn fence. It's north of the lake. It looks like there should be a trail somewhere on the north shore of Jonesy Lake.
I'll start hiking that way now. God damn it, my head.
Are you sure you saw what you saw, Henry? Maybe you pissed off some more campers and they came back to sucker punch you.
Why would I make this up? It's an insane lie at worst and a shitty prank at best.
And you've been feeling okay?
I feel fine.
Okay, I'm sorry. I believe you, but that conversation was from 2 weeks ago.
I know they were, so... What's to say that they don't have transcripts from 3, 4, or 5 weeks ago?
Our entire relationship, friendship, our Our whole summer.
Someone is out here with the walkie-talkie, taking notes and talking to God knows who. What do you think is going on behind that fence?
Apparently a lot of following you around taking notes, which is unfucking believable, Henry.
Yeah, you're telling me. All right, I'm on my way to Wapiti Meadow. I'll let you know what I find.
Okay. There's got to be a reasonable explanation. Also, I'm gonna call around and see if anyone's had anything weird happen to them or seemed spooked. I don't want to make this bigger than it is yet, you know?
Yeah, understood.
Yeah, okay. Hike safe.
Just want to ask about the trail.
I've got an overgrown trail here.
Yeah, that'll happen.
So I'm screwed when it comes to getting past it?
Mm-hmm. Screwed until you clear it yourself, yeah.
Great. Well, if I come across some tools, I'll add groundskeeping to my ever-increasing list of responsibilities.
Jeez. Not fun. Not fun. North of Jonesy Lake is this way, right? Yep, I think so. Dear God. Are we going crazy? What is this? Sure, we can walk this way. Oh, there's a cache over there. Old sweater. University of Eastern Colorado. The Fourth Estate. Same author. Must be another murder mystery. Neil Black thought a trip to California would do him good. He'd soak up some sun, drive a convertible, and maybe employ a poolside drink with a tiny umbrella. Blah blah blah. California is nothing but a dream. Emergency landing after a murder in first class. Dun dun dun. Shit.
Hey, who are these guys, Ron and Dave? They're leaving notes for each other in the boxes. Is there any chance that they had anything to do with those girls disappearing?
No, they're both rangers. They're not out here this season. I didn't really know them that well, but I always assumed the only thing Ron cared about was chasing tail and getting loaded. It's somehow comforting to know that he was able to keep up a correspondence with someone who wasn't going to send him a topless Polaroid.
Did you get my note about what went down at Wapiti? Sheriff isn't too pleased with me, but I don't know, I probably overdid it. Wish you would have been there. Guess you must have got hung up. P.S. Amigos is Spanish and Profesionales is Italian. Thanks for letting me know, Dave. Not sure what new information this piece provided. Over there? Aaron? Summer 79? Huh. Not too sure. Yeah, I have no clue what that one added. Well, okay. I guess the only thing to do is keep going. What is this way? Wait. Oh, this is the correct way. Okay, in that case then, I'm gonna go this way first. Duck. Ducks and geese and... Okay. Guess we gotta keep going this way. Even if we get to the fence though, we don't have, like, any tools. So I'm not too sure how that's gonna work out. That looks so on purpose. Yeah, I'm not gonna take a picture of that. Delilah? You haven't spoken in a while. Chop down. We don't have an axe. Oh, wow.
Okay, I'm at the fence. I don't see anyone around, but I'm not sure I can get past it.
How big is it?
Big. It goes off in both directions. Acres.
But what the fuck is going on out here?
Whatever it is, someone doesn't want anyone to know about it.
Sometimes biologists will cordon off a little area to study flora or whatever, but that's only a few square feet usually.
That's not what this is.
We'll see what you can do to get past it.
Looks like goddamn Area 51.
Maybe they've got aliens. That'd be exciting.
Yeah, we'll see about that. And what are the odds they left the gate unlocked?
Pretty low, I'd imagine.
I don't want to go in there! Why is the fence perpetually rattling like that? Oh my god!
Look, I'm not gonna be able to get into this place.
Good.
Shit.
I don't know how long I can dick around out here until someone notices.
God, if you were an actual firefighter, you'd have that gate down in two shakes. Hey, actually, those guys doing the controlled burn, they might be able to help.
Where are they?
Beyond Ruby River, there's a scout camp. They burned a line a few days ago that should let you hike right to them.
Well, that's great.
If they haven't left, they're probably the type of guys who would help you get through that fence.